What is going on, guys? Wise here, and coming to you with a very special episode of OneHive Labs. This is going to be a Town Hall 9 base breakdown scouting and planning discussion with 2.0's very own McGrady. So what's up, McGrady? How you doing?
Hey, Wiser. How are you? Excellent. Happy to be here.
Excellent. How are things over in Spain?
Dude, everything's fine here. It started not being as warm as it used to be. So, well, it is what it is.
Still jealous, actually. My clutch, my brother-in-law, gets to come see you, I hear, pretty soon, so that's kind of cool.
Yeah, maybe we meet up for a beer or something.
That's what he's hoping. So anyways, let's get on to this video here. For those of you that don't know, or if you don't follow the recaps, because if you do follow the recaps, you definitely know who McGrady is, but he's definitely one of 2.0's strongest Town Hall 9 attackers. It's a rarity when he fails the base, and we're going to kind of tell you why, and he's going to go in a little bit in depth about we're going to show a base, first of all, that Invicta struggled with a while back, and it was really good at defending for it was the Dark Knights, I believe.
Yeah, I believe so.
So we're just going to kind of talk about the base a little bit, talk about some things that Grady saw when he was planning the cleanup of this attack, and he's going to go into detail. So I'm going to hop on over to this Twiddler here. Me and Grady are checking it out right now. So kind of lead us into this, Grady. What when you look at this base, what do you think?
Okay. So first of all, let's bring some context. Like the, when we faced this base, it was a very close war in Invicta. And this base had been attacked like 6 or 7 times. I cannot remember how many. And every attack was very close. And the thing is that once you will know where the traps and Teslas and everything is, you will guess why is that. Because this trap, this base, what has is like it has many like what's it called, false friends or something like that, that you would think that the base is easier than it actually is, and you need to plan for it and be very precise on what you need to take out and what's valuable and what's not. Because I think what happened here is that we maybe misread that, and we thought that getting a couple of objectives was enough. I think that everyone had a read that they wanted to exploit in this base somehow, whether it was air or it was ground. Everyone saw like this jump here coming from the queen compartment. They thought that they thought that they would have half of the base open, and like that was it. Like they could take both expos, they could take a lot of air defenses if they went air, and the sweepers also, and they could kill the queen and the CC, and that was it. But it was not
the problem. I was gonna say ends up being you don't even really get to the jump because of certain factors, right? Like there's steps you need to take to get there, and if you noticed down here on either sides, that's not an easy funnel to create by any means. You got this wizard tower out there that's going to yank you, right? This mortar over here that if you put things too far out are going to go over there. So there's a lot to think about when entering towards that jump you're speaking of.
Exactly. And the first time you approach this phase, even you have to, like, everyone wanted to start from 6, which I don't think it's the best entry. And they read this exploit, and everyone kind of wanted to find an attack that used that exploit. And in the end, when we cleaned up this attack, like, we did the same, but we used that exploit. And the idea was to show that if you find the best synergies on your attacks, like you can triple the bases anyway at TH9. It basically comes down to having a good read and good troops, and there's several attacks that can work on a base. You just have to be very, very precise on the execution if you want an attack to fall through. And the thing is that when you don't know the base and you try and scout it, you may think that there's a Tesla farm here, for instance, or just Teslas scattered around, maybe one outside to mess up with your funnel here. I don't know. Like when you first attack it, you just don't know where everything is. And the thing is that the usual funnel everyone did in this base, the usual approach was using either 2 or 3 columns, starting like here, using those 2 mortars. And what everyone made sure is to open the wall here, so the mortars would go inside and not go outside, just like you said, Wiser, that you have to be careful if you drop your golem like here, there's a chance that it goes like that, and I believe it happened once or twice on attacks on our side. But yeah, basically the main idea was like to bring some golem force here, some bowlers also, so everyone spent several troops to try and funnel something like that, like take all those buildings away, this one as well, and try and send everything from this location. Bowlers, heroes, try and jump here. Obviously, what you usually do is try and poison the queen, poison the CC, rage your bowlers. I'm using the colors that we usually use. So that's a rage spell, those are two poisons, and that's a jump spell. And then from this, like what usually people thought it was like, maybe it's important to preserve the golems and bowlers' health, and maybe they need to use a heal spell on this location. And doing that, they have access to, if you are very precise with it, you can take away as much as this on the base, something like that. Like you have access to all this for sure,
Yeah.
and maybe a little bit more. So if you take this away, you know that there's a lot of point defenses that you can target either with, let's say, loons or hawks, whatever you fancy. And even if you thought that you could send more hawks from this location, from like the location here at 9, you send some hawks, they go towards this, and that you can reinforce as you think that you need to,
That's why
and everything.
I think a lot of people lean towards hogs, I believe, on this base because of that fact. Like there's no room for even spring traps in a lot of spots, at least good ones. And
Exactly.
it looks very tempting, right? It written down on paper.
Exactly. That's what you would think. Like, if you think about different funnels, like we said, like, okay, let's enter at 4. That's a lot of point defenses there. Yeah, okay, but there's this building, this building, this building. There's a lot of high HP that you have to account for, and by the time you kill those, your golems are dead, and you don't have any protection. And like the queen is so far away if you go in a different entry, so we stayed away from that and we kept the original funnel. The thing is that I was talking to Wiser before we started this video about what I usually do when I try and do a TH9 attack, and I basically follow the three steps, the very three easy steps. I just scout whatever I can. I try and read where the objectives are and what are the threats and what do I want to accomplish. And at the very end, it's when I do the exact planning. It's where I try and find the better funnel, good synergies for everything, like the best path for my troops to go, and also plan for the cleanup if I can. Like you can usually tell, for instance, like we said, there's a lot of high HP buildings here, and if you are sending your hawks from this location, and like everyone will go towards this and finish here, because everything else will be taken care like will be killed by your kill squad. That means that those three high HP buildings won't be targeted for a very long time. So that what it tells me is that you may want to send wizards early on here, so they can kill all the trash and go path towards here and kill those buildings because they will be in range and they are very high HP. And if you are very diligent with this and you are very certain about everything, you can send the wizards fairly early. Like you can send your first, let's say, 3 to 6 hawks at 9, and you can send the wizards right away. You don't have to wait at the end of the attack. That's something that people sometimes does. They just do kill squad first, now hawks, and once I know everything is going okay, then I will start my cleanup. That's not something I usually do. I try and find a ways to be quicker so I can have room for any mistakes or anything that I can not account for.
I talk
So,
about it.
okay.
I talk about it all the time. You have to start that early cleanup. It makes or breaks so many raids sometimes.
It
If
is.
you have that cleanup going while main sort of phases of your attacks are being executed, it's just, you're saving yourself time.
Okay, so then about this base, like you would think that this type of attack would work and it would be fine. You had a spare heal to heal your hogs or whatever, and the thing is, like, then when we know where the traps and the Teslas were, that's when the fun started. Because there's a DGB here, which is okay-ish. Like, you can kill it with your kill squad, and then your hawks don't path through it. So that should be okay. But then there's some spring traps to be accounted for, which is one here. One here that you can easily lose three hawks on, and that's another one. There is a, sorry, let me draw this. I always use blue for spring traps. I always use orange for skelly traps, and red for giant bombs. So those three spring traps, you could have thought about it earlier. And then there's like this very big trap that, well, if you don't plan for it, you will fall.
Tesla
which
farm.
Is, yeah, there's a Tesla here. There's a bomb here. Also, there are some skellies here. I believe there are some here as well. And it's not actually a Tesla farm because there's a Tesla here as well. But you have a Tesla here, and a brutal double spring trap here. So let's say that you send with the usual Goboho attack, you have three golems, a CC full of bowlers, and then you have room for about 15 to 18 hawks, depending on how many funneling troops or cleanup troops you need. So let's say that you used 15, you can easily lose three here. If you don't have a heal for this giant bomb, you can lose some hawks
everything.
On this way. Yeah, basically everything, but at least some hawks.
Yeah.
There's a high chance to lose between three and six hawks on this spring trap, and also lose three more at the very end, because nothing else can target those if you send the hawks very early, or I don't know, like if you are not patient enough or you don't have any different plans. Look at it, like three plus six plus three on the worst scenario possible, that's 12 hawks. The staggering amount of 12 hawks killed while some skellies are chasing you, some other skellies are chasing you here.
There's a bomb.
And
yeah.
And there was another bomb, yeah, sure. It was, yeah, next to that Tesla as well at the very end. So, yeah, like, easily, like, I believe it's right here. So, what it happens is that the base builder might have thought about this plan that we are just doing, like, being the easiest one, or the first one that you would think of. Let's single target everything from the outside, like, in a very, what's it called, a very... when you send your hawks on
surgical.
A targeted defense. Exactly, surgical.
Yeah.
Thank you. And the thing is that if you go surgical, you have to be very, very precise, because if you are not, you're going to lose all your hawks. And if you lose the worst case scenario, 12 hawks plus all the skellies and so on, easily you run out of hawks. You have like 2 to 4 hawks alive, or maybe less than that. Maybe your golems are dead, and so on. And well, that was the main problem with this base. So
yeah,
let me...
he set it up well for that. And even in the same, yep. I've thrown this base up for friendly challenges a few times. Like, I've had it for a while now since you gave it to me to build for this very episode. Guys even struggle a lot with air, and mainly because of that whole that same whole section. This side is deadly for back end units.
It is, and even when people went air with this attack, the base builder smartly placed those two black bombs here precisely for that. Like, if you come from down there and you get the access to those defenses, like maybe three air defenses or two of them, and you try and kill the sweepers, like if you look at them, they are pointing on these directions. So you are kind of not forced, but you are advised to try and kill it like that. If you try to dragon swap here, there's a bomb here as well. So yeah, like, he tried and find ways to force you to use some things that you wouldn't use. And yeah, those Teslas plus the two black bombs, they killed the loons quite fast, and it's hard to go that with just like investing so much on your kill squad.
Absolutely.
So all this talking. what did I do to try and adjust the original plan? Like, the original plan went like that, and it was a 95% attack. And then what we did is what we changed it up a little bit, and we try and get the 100%. And sorry, excuse me for a second.
Yeah, no worries, no worries. Go ahead.
Okay.
Really, what Grady I know is talking about is there was issues in almost every attack on the entry, like right from the get-go, and a lot of it was because of these sections right here. You even if you pre-poison that queen down there, if you drop those golems in on those mortars, they're going to be taking a lot of damage very, very early and very, very quickly. So definite adjustments needed to be made on that entry just to preserve the push into the base. You back, Grady?
I'm jumping back in. Yeah,
Beautiful.
that's exactly one of the first things that we talked about, and that's something that people are forgetting. To preserve the golem health, it's just crucial for your bowlers. Like, it's not the same to send your bowlers when they are well protected with let's say two or three golems, sorry, and they can tank forever, or sending them like giving free health. Like, never, never do that. So, what you have to do, the first thing, like the initial thing you have to think about, I will keep the some arrows, but you have to try and find smart ways to funnel. Usually, the best troop to do that is either minions or baby drags. In this case, what I saw is that there were a lot of buildings to kill. Like, if you count them, it's like one, two, three, which is a big one, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, another big one, 11, maybe even 12, and maybe even 13 here. So that's a lot of buildings to kill. Like, you have to be smart with that, because if you are not, your wizards will take a long time, or you need a lot of wizards to kill that and a lot of time to do that. You waste a lot of troops, and when you realize it, it snowballs really, really early, and well, like, you don't have enough troops to kill the rest of the base, because as we said, there's a lot of traps on this base, and you have to try and preserve everything you can. So, the first thing I did is, let me remove all those numbers, but is realizing that the entry was quite safe to use minions on, because the threats that I had were basically the Archer Towers. Let me remove these as well. But basically, the minion threat is the Archer Towers, the Teslas, where I knew where they were, and there's another Archer Tower here. So there's the three Archer Towers that I have to be careful about. There's no air defenses that may be a threat for me, or neither Teslas, because I know where they are at this point in the war. So what I thought it was like using a minion here in this location, another one here at six, another one here, and try and squeeze one here. But I am not sure if this Archer Tower is in range of these gold storage. But the idea was like starting early minions, they start and do some work, and they can kill some buildings and remove them, so I can invest less wizards. And not only that, but also be quicker at wall breaking in, thus preserving my golem's health so much more. Because let's say that you are sending your golems first and you are using wizards behind. Like, you would think that this is fine, and nothing is wrong with doing that, but in this case it's quite not efficient, and you are letting a lot of defenses, which is the, let me remove things to be clear. I'm sorry, guys, because I'm not very polite when I let's not polite, but clean when I am doing my things. So the thing is that you let this cannon shoot at you let this expo, you let this queen shoot at you, and if you can avoid that somehow, that's always positive.
Well, here's a question too. How much time does it take a wizard to kill a mine or a pump?
I don't know exactly, but I'm sure that
Yeah, like
it
6 seconds, something like
yeah,
that.
5 seconds, 6 seconds, something like that. Because if the wizard the wizard is like 120 damage or something like that, and the health is like 700, yeah, something like that. So yeah, let's say like you invest 6 seconds of your time killing those things with the wizard, and then like 6 or 7 seconds more to kill the next layer of buildings. And if those are the storages, that's more. That's you can double it like easily. And if you're using two wizards, let's say, well, that's 7 seconds again. So that means that you have invested like 14 or 17 seconds, which doesn't feel like a lot, of a cannon hitting at you, an X-bow hitting at you, and an archer tower hitting at you, plus the queen. Even if you poison her,
Yeah.
the poison doesn't last
That's what I
for
say.
forever. It lasts for a little time. So it can something very wrong can happen, which means that you realize that the poison is going away, and you suddenly drop another poison on the queen because you know that that's a big threat to you, and then you don't have a poison for the baby dragon, the CC.
Yep. It's a
Problem.
domino effect, right? I mean,
Yeah.
and the fact that you take those down ahead of time just means your wizards and your higher DPS units, you can drop that much closer to the wall. They're going to target that cannon that much quicker and stop that DPS, all that DPS, slowly start chunking it down a lot quicker. So it's like it's a domino effect, right? It's not just that 6 seconds. It's getting you just such a better position for the rest of your troops.
Value you are getting, you are preserving 10 seconds of defenses shooting at your golems, which you can easily tell that's always positive for you, because if you don't tank for that at the start, it means that you can tank for that later on the raid. And well, that's the very first thing. Like I try and find smart places where to use my minions. I can see also, like, if you want to be super extra efficient with this, also, there's no threats on this location. You can safely send a minion here if you know that there's no red bombs there, but it can kill those buildings easily. So you can start your funneling, your cleanup quite early. And yeah, that's the main location that I can think of. Maybe even here you can find another smart trade, or maybe even here. And
At the very least, you got to make note, especially that builder's hut in the corner. I mean, those little
Exactly.
details, guys, on the cleanup planning, you just need to know. I mean, you just need to know if your troops pass by it or you don't account for it early. You got to have a troop at the end for it because it could make or break the raid.
Absolutely, absolutely. Like, for instance, let's say we talked about synergies as well. I'm sorry that I'm not being very organized in this very first one, the video that we do, but let's talk about when you send the hawks from this location, and you try and think, okay, like, it's a smart thing to send the wizards right behind. Then be even smarter than that, and don't send the wizards like here, and let them path towards here and maybe leave this building behind. Like, don't do that. Be smart about it and send the wizards here. They will path here and they will take their time to kill the trash buildings untouched, because the defense will be killed beforehand. So that's something that we maybe can go deeper on another video or something like that. But the idea here, like, if we can get like two or three ideas to stick for this video, and for whoever watches this to use them on their cleanup attacks, like, that's perfect, and that's something that if it serves to someone, that's a lot that we can accomplish with this video. Okay,
Definitely.
so preserving the golem's health, that's something very important if you are using your bowlers behind them. That's the first thing. And the other thing is, be very patient with your hawks. If you're using hawks, or if you're using let's say that you're using your loons, that's the same exact thing. Okay, so let's say that you have the start figured out, you are using a couple of minions to try and kill early buildings, and then you will use your golems, you will use your wizards to funnel the rest that you need to funnel, and then you use, like you guys have said, the boulders very early, so you can kill the defenses faster, thus preserving everything that much faster as well. Okay, so let's say that you're using this, and you're using that rage. Okay, that's all good and okay, but you need to know what happens next for you. Then that's something that the follow-up, something like it doesn't get thought about, and that's something that I think people should do, because it's something that you can easily plan, and that you can try and take advantage of. What's my point here? That one thing that I did is, like, everyone wanted to open the base so much, and they wanted to place this jump to open the three compartments and try and have access to everything. But that's something that I think it's not very good, because if you do that, there's a higher chance that everything, all your troops scatter around, and when you have one bowler targeting one defense and another bowler targeting another defense, and then the bowlers, the golems, they split apart, and one goes here and another one goes here, and you don't really have a control on that.
It's been a constant theme, honestly, in my recaps of trying to create the unis, you know, the what's the word I'm looking for, the rotation around the base, whether it's clockwise or counterclockwise, and keeping your troops in, you know, together, right, and forcing that. It's so important, right? Because I use this Valk attacks, right? If your Valk split off, the raid sucks, right? The same idea. Your bowler split off, your hog split off, your miner split off. It carries through to like every attack. You got to get that, you know, unison movement of your kill.
Exactly. You have to be very, very knowledgeable about what you are doing with this attack. And what you are doing basically is that you are slowly killing the base with your golems and bowlers. And what you are doing is like you have a ball of death. So if you scatter these troops and don't keep them together, you lose a lot of power, because you are not following the best synergy that you can have with these troops. So what I did here is that I thought that this compartment here wasn't a threat to me, and I could reach that anytime in the moment with this base. Like, if my raid does this like clockwise motion and it ends like here, at some point, these buildings will be killed and accounted for. And there's not really a lot of threats like touching this compartment. There's just one Tesla and one Archer Tower, which is just two defenses. So I thought that it was better doing it like this and placing the jump exactly here and accomplishing this with doing that. What I wanted to do is, like, I wanted to tank for it. This, maybe this, and this as well. Which means is that I would not send my hogs until I knew that my golems were tanking for those.
Then you need to heal.
Exactly.
Yep.
Exactly. And by doing that, what I did as the follow-up, as the natural follow-up, is like, you can send your hogs from this location, and you can send very few because you know that they are not going to be killed. And you can predict their path very well, because you know that all this section has been killed, so you know that your hogs will path towards this straight up. I knew that there wasn't any spring traps on this location. Maybe there was one here, but that's not a threat if you send the hogs in this motion that I just draw, and because you can take the buildings one at a time, and then they path towards the inside. And if you are patient enough, your golems will single trigger the bombs, so that's not a threat to you. And sending fewer hogs here, like let's say two, even if they path towards that, like that's two hogs that you may lose to a DGP spot, which is okay, because you have 10 to 12 more that then you will send here, which also, look at it, like, it just about those synergies that we talked about. Like, let's say that your golems are going through this location. When they have to make a decision where to go next, if the charm is placed like this, they just have one choice, which is go towards this. And once you kill all those defenses, the golems will try and find the closest defense they can target. And if the charm is placed like that, they can go to the air defense, as their only choice. And their next pathing here is obviously through the expo, like this, and then you get a chance to have even these defenses targeted for you. Okay. So, that being said, with all those arrows, that may be very confusing if you are not following everything for us, but please leave a comment.
Doing exactly what I've been talking about. You're getting a clockwise rotation on your kill squad, and you're surgically reinforcing with the hogs, protecting the hogs at with the kill squad, and just getting the double duty value on your troops.
Exactly. So, let's say I'm sending two hogs from either of the every arrow that I just drawn, and by that time, at this exact point in the raid, what you have been taking account from is this part of the base, exactly this. So that's what's left, and you can see that there's four Teslas, 3-point defenses, which is still quite a lot of things to kill. For this raid, you have invested already 3 golems, a CC full of bowlers, and 12 hogs. So likely there's 3 hogs remaining, or 3 to 6 hogs remaining, and you have to kill so many things still. So that's where the trickiest part of the raid comes, which is like if you saved as many hogs as you could, that's a good time to use them and try and keep. Preserving this motion that you just talked about, the clockwise motion, like this. And maybe, since there's a lot of threats here, maybe there's an opportunity for you to send a troop here, maybe a giant, maybe... I believe I used the bulk. I had this thought-out idea, but I thought that the bulk would path here first and then here. So I could trigger a spring trap to preserve my hogs. I thought my hogs were more important. And that's basically it. And also I thought that if my hogs were going in a clockwise motion, like the one you described, I would have those skellies on my tail and I wouldn't have any poisons because I would have used them earlier for the CC kill and Archer Queen kill. So I thought that maybe there was this chance that my Valk would kill some skellies as well and getting that much value because skellies at the very end, they are troops that do damage. So yeah, that was very, very, I don't know, like...
It was a very overzealous
idea. Yeah, it was very iffy. Yeah, but I cannot remember since it was like very long time ago if it did work very well or it just like triggered the spring trap and died and that's it. But the purpose of it was to like even save my hogs a little bit more and clean up a little bit better.
And what I guess we maybe can just leave the overall plan at is every section is accounted for. And even like just going down, yeah, you had this idea for one specific troop. He was going to get in there and do, you know, trigger a spring trap. Like those are the little details, guys, that make the difference. And, you know, that's, as you can see by Grady's plan here, like it's very extremely thought out. Every part of the base is accounted for.
To wrap the plan up and leave it like this, if there were 2 DGBs here, so I thought that a heal placed in this location would benefit my bowlers if some stepped too far away, would help my golems, because why not? Preserving golems' health is always good. And if some hogs path through that location and the bombs were single-triggered, my hogs would benefit from that as well. So that's a heal that's healing bowlers, heroes, golems, and hogs at the same time, which to my thought process, that's a lot of value.
Absolutely.
And also I knew that I needed a heal here somehow, or maybe another one here. Like, there were two giant bomb spots that there were potential threats to me, so that was kind of a situational heal. So there's a lot of arrows here, but the idea is like you do this entry, try and preserve the golem's health as we said. That's one very important thing that everyone can do on their attacks, and try and find smart traps for your funnels. Minions are a very useful troop to funnel, to pick a building here and there. And yeah, that's basically it. Try and preserve the health of your troops, try and preserve the troops overall. And at the very end, like if there's a Tesla and a giant bomb, but I have 10 hogs alive, two golems alive, and like all my bowlers alive, I don't care if there's just one Tesla and one bomb. I have
Wow.
so many troops that everything will get killed. And and GG, basically.
All right, so you're ready to put your money where your mouth is, so to
I'm so ready. I'm so ready. Do you
say.
have your CC filled with
Yeah, I
it?
got the troops. I got the troops. It's a standard war CC, so be ready for it.
Believe
Let's
I.
take a quick pause and we can get set up and maybe grab a quick drink or something, and we will be back with Grady's live friendly challenges on this base. And Grady is ready to rock here. Now, a couple little things we were discussing, kind of in the downtime there. The entry overall, we weren't a fan of. Like, we both agreed that if it were up to us, and if Grady didn't make the hit in the war, and have such close attempts using that entry, and you know, he probably would have went at it a whole different way. So we wanted to maybe we wanted to we're gonna try first of all what the other guys did. We're gonna try the adjustments that Grady made based on what the other guys did, and then we're just gonna say screw it, let's just go with a whole, sort of a whole different entry, and we're gonna see what the difference is here. So does that sound good to you, buddy?
It sounds perfect, Wiser. Like, hopefully we will show everything we wanted to show. And yeah, we had the analysis thing. Basically, the whole idea of the screw thing and go for the different plan is going for the objectives we talked about in the first part, like reading where the Teslas and spring traps are and actually valuing the spring traps. That's something that sometimes doesn't happen on your usual attack. So yeah. Like we will see that hopefully on the live attacks. So let's start with the first
Yeah, let's do it.
whenever you're
I
ready.
am posting. Is it the right one? That is the right one. Greedy. All right, buddy, good luck. Well, sort of. This is
Well, exactly.
the.
That's the let's fail attack. Just so all of us remember, basically I will use the wizards right away, and I will not poison the queen, and or I'll poison her a little bit too late.
Two golems in quickly, right?
Yep, exactly. Like I started doing the three golems and then the wizards, and then I poisoned the queen, which is something that you have to be aware if you want to do or not. And everything seems to be working just fine. But as you can see, there's not that many golems alive. There's not a lot of health of them. And I'm waiting for the CC to come out. There it is. I will connect everything the guy's connected. I will poison. And let's get those going. Bowlers are going out.
Ugh.
Yeah. Which is something that can happen if you don't plan for your funnel. That totally can happen.
You do have the golems in there doing some tanking for the queen, so that's kind of nice, but again, it's very, you lost stuff too quickly, right? Like even the poison on the clan castle, not having that pre-poison down, knowing exactly when the clan castle is going to come out after your troops.
Sure,
A lot
absolutely.
Allowed those Valks to get in there and do some good damage. Your king went down very quickly.
Yep, he did, and now I have like a lot of hogs alive, but I can tell that there's two spring traps that just killed half of them. There's skellies chasing, PK chasing. I still have to go through 4 point defenses, and I'm not going to. I have my queen alive, and she will get some damage for sure, but I can already tell that it's not likely going to be enough. Like, I can try my best now, but since I didn't protect my golems at the start, even though they like went ahead perfectly and they protected my queen for quite a while, you can tell that they run out of juice. And you can tell that you have 4 point defenses left that had my bolus better been funneled and had my queen went behind. And like, if they will stay alive, this is a 3-star, but since they did not, well, that's a high 80-90% attack that actually doesn't cut it for us on
nope.
the on an elite level. We won the 3-star.
All right.
So, well, let's let this one end, but
yep.
You can already tell that it's 88%. Let's try and do the same exact entry, but with a little tweaks to try and get the 3-star. Let's go for it. Exact same troop composition. And we will do the early minions as we set. I will let them run for a little while. I will start my golem very, very far away. So I have time to deploy a couple of wizards. I have time to deploy a little bit more here, another wizard here, and I can be quicker on protecting her. Like, even though this golem is going to get smoked anyway, there it goes.
There we go, King's locked on.
I'll switch this, I'll pre-poison. Everything is going as expected. My bowlers walked.
No, it's that stupid gold mine.
Yep, I didn't protect my wizards well enough, but I think I'm fine anyway.
The king is alive in there.
Yep, and I have still two heals that I will try and use as efficient as I can.
Overlap that king. That's good heal. Keep him going just a little bit. Defensive king locking onto your golems is huge too, because now it's not chasing your hogs.
Exactly, exactly. That's what all we talked about. And I will try and protect my queen as much as I can. My hogs, there's such a group of hogs alive now. And yeah, basically all the defenses are dead and some hogs are alive.
Much better. All you got is the skellies. That's definitely going to be a 3.
Yep, that's a 3-star. Like, that's not the perfect 3-star, and the bowler's walk, which is not what you want in your raid, but just because my golems were much more protected at the start, just because, like, I send the minions at the start, well, you can tell there's half of the some golem knights I can see, and some hogs alive, and with 30 seconds to spare.
The small bomb almost took out a few. Nice
yeah,
job,
that
buddy.
Would have been so funny. Okay.
So that's actually perfect because it's exactly what we talked about. The little tweaks can make the difference. However, I still don't think that you think or you feel at the end of that attack that was a clean attack. Like that, you weren't confident, I don't think. If you know what I'm saying? Like you weren't fully confident, like knowing that was going to be a 3-star. And that's what you want.
Right,
that's
exactly.
What you want more. You want to feel comfortable with your entry. You want to know you're going to smash into a certain part of the base, and you don't want your bowlers to walk in and just kind of hope that it works
exactly.
out, right? So how
exactly.
do we do that?
Okay, so there's always a plan hiding somewhere, and we kind of give it a spin. And using a similar strategy, but in a different entry, I think that we go towards the objectives much more faster. Like the Tesla farm is a big concern. So many spring traps on those locations that we mentioned are a concern as well. And yeah, I think that there's a different way to approach this space. And we kind of change it up a little bit, and I think that I can just goal, and with the troops I changed on my original composition. I've added a little bit of funneling troops, and that's it, basically.
Yep.
And a second jump, I think that we can triple this base much more easily. That happens sometimes, right? Like,
yeah. One thing I mention actually in videos occasionally, or thing as we're talking, is a lot of times you get even in just in chat, I find it sucks because when someone comes up with a plan, that's the plan they're probably most comfortable with. And a lot of times when guys are looking at a base, it's almost like they're looking at it with horse blinders because they're looking at a sketch that someone else did. Whereas there could potentially be, not always, but could potentially just be a better plan altogether, right? So that's something we try and promote in our clan and promote in our planning, and you know, make sure no one's taking a chip off their shoulder because someone has a completely different idea than maybe what you came up with. But a lot of it comes down to what you're comfortable with at the same time. But
exactly,
doesn't
exactly
mean it's the best plan.
I agree with you. In the end, there's not just a single way to triple a base, and I don't think there's luck in clash, but sometimes things go just your way. Like, and yeah, I feel that we can triple this base much more easily. So,
all right.
Whenever you are ready, we can give it a go.
You are posted up. Good luck, buddy.
Okay. Let's go with this one. Ready when you are.
I am in live.
Let's do this. So, basically, we are doing a very different entry than the original one. We are focusing a Tesla farm and first with the bowlers, and we've checked that if we think deeply about the funnel, there's a very good way to triple this base much faster and ensure the bowlers are going in. So I'm just going to do it.
Because it is still a very tricky funnel on that side of the base.
It so is. It so is.
I love that one mini for the three red mines at the beginning, though. That's awesome.
Yeah, he's the best. Let's make sure I don't make a wall breaker fail, which is always something that you want to avoid.
The double jump's going to get you there. In goes your kinger. Of course the queen goes up, though. You kind of want that, though. As soon as that clan castle goes down, you're going to go right to that defensive queen, I believe.
I think so. Let's use the ability early.
Yep, there goes that king. She's about to lock on. Poison is down on her nice and early.
Yep. I believe that, let's see what the bowlers do, but there's a, oh, the jump was a little bit, oh, the jump was early.
Yeah.
Yep, but anyhow, that was my mistake on the execution, I believe, but the golems were.
You just needed that expo to go down.
Yeah, and everything else was fine. We just tripled it like a second ago.
Yeah.
But yeah, that doesn't happen live. Anyhow, the thing is that what we wanted to show, which is that there's different entries, I think it's clear. Like, you can see that we have the two columns with a very high HP right now, and they will be protecting the queen. I think that I'm not getting it because of time, but the queen will be alive and the columns will be as well. Just because, like, they didn't route correctly, and just the jump was not
faded, like with a set, like literally with a second. They looked at it and they're like, "Oh no." Nope.
yeah, exactly. But if you look at it, that I'm certain that I would have tripled it. The idea is what I wanted to suggest. I think it's correct, and that's just an execution mistake. But sometimes there are different entries that you can abuse, and yeah, like, I encourage people to check the objective, check what the threats are, and and find the best way to three star base.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, it also goes to show what a lot of it comes down to execution. Like, you can do, you know, I actually, just this last war, I made a cleanup hit on someone who got a 98%. And the first question I got when I posted my plan was, well, why don't you just copy the 98%? And when I watched the replay, it was a super long queen sort of walk charged, like she charged into this
Okay.
big open part of the base. I forget, there was a few things like it didn't seem plausible to replicate very easily, and I wasn't comfortable with it. But what I did do, I watched that replay like 10 times. Why? Because I wanted to take in the proper information, but I wanted to still go with the entry and the attack that I was comfortable with. And I think a combination of the two got me the 3-star, but like I crushed it, absolutely crushed it compared to, if I had tried to mimic that 98%, even if your troop placement is slightly off, you might not get it.
Exactly. It has happened us so many times when you just place your queen one tile on the left, and then, like, I don't know, something that didn't affect the first raid, like BK walking on the side of your queen because she pathed like just a tile differently, and then the raid completely changes, and like to adjust on the fly, and it was supposed to be a 98% attack, and it is not, and you get like like an idiot face and an 80% attack, and you're like, what the hell just happened?
Yeah, because
Anyhow, I think I want to give it another try while you
okay.
talk, if it's okay with you.
Yep,
Like,
I'm gonna
I'll
post it
just
up and we
execute
will
it a little
watch.
bit better, and we can finish the conversation
Okay, you're posted.
while I'm attacking. So yeah, just take it away. I will just do my thing.
And actually, my response, it was Z-Bear actually that said, why don't you just copy the attack? And I'm like, I actually don't like doing that. And a lot of it is because the slightest change causes a domino effect on the raid, and if there's one little tiny thing that is different, the entire raid can be different. And as you'll see here, if Grady maybe nails this triple, it's almost the exact same attack. It looks like almost the exact same troop placement, but maybe the baby D goes a different way because you were slightly off, and some building didn't get funneled, pulls your other troops to a place you didn't want them to go to, and the whole raid is different. So I would say in general, when you're planning cleanups, guys, think about what you're most comfortable with, but still at the same time, you're using the person who attacked in front of you's replay to gain as much of the information as you possibly can, just to make it go as smooth as it possibly can, right? Because in this instance, yeah, the king walked around.
Yeah, dude, like I'm not having my day execution wise. It happens sometimes. Sometimes it is
I'm
just
kind of
what it
interested
is.
in how this is going to work out because that golem's going to hop into the queen chamber. I don't know if the king's going to make it around in time here.
There's the queen behind, so
Yeah, I don't know, man.
I don't know. I don't know.
The queen's going to take out that defensive queen. Come on, queen. Get her. All right, so she's down.
The expo.
Golem's in there tanking. Wizard's helping out on the expo.
Yep. Let's hope cleanup is not a
It's going
problem.
to be just coming down to cleanup. There is that building
Yeah.
shut at 6 might be a problem because
Yeah.
everything's.
And I have no troops at all. Let me
No.
pop this ability early so I have more archers. I have a full minute left and there's no defenses. Like the queen will take the archer. Okay, yeah. There's a bowler doing work. I don't know. It's gonna be
It's gonna be
close, but
close.
yeah, but you can tell that it was my mistake because I forgot my BK. I was so mesmerized by your talking, like you are
Yes, of
so right.
course. Of course, I
So
distracted
right.
you.
The are so right because yeah, it has happened to me so many times that it happens. Just it happens. Like a feedback is not an easy thing. But yeah, anyhow, this is my mistake because I'm not executing very well lately. But you can tell that this plan just send a PK a little bit early, and dude, I'm about to get a 90, like a
Maybe a 99.
97. I don't think I get the 99 because of my hero level. But hey, I think that wraps it up. And even though we couldn't demonstrate because I'm just executing so bad, still, I think that proves our point. And I just hope that people get better, cleanups get better 3 stars. And if that video helps, that would be amazing.
Yep, absolutely. So I think to sum it up, you have to be comfortable with your attack. I'm never a fan of telling people to do something that they're not comfortable with. If someone does a lalo a lot, telling them to do a lalo is probably not going to work out well. But at the same token, the second thing, you need to make sure that you're gathering as much information from the cleanup replay as you can, and just applying it to your attack, and you should have pretty good success. So, anyhow, Grady, I think we'll wrap this up, buddy. But thanks for coming out. Thanks for showing me this. That's a tough base, to be honest. I see why Invictus struggled with it a little bit in that war. So shouts out to whoever built that base, because we did steal. I'm pretty sure that base was stolen from someone else and then put in the war that we faced it in, because I know clanmates have seen that base prior to that war. But anyhow, anything else you'd like to add before we shut her down here?
I think that wraps it all. And thank you again for having me. And
my pleasure, buddy. My pleasure. But that'll do it here for your wisdom from Wiser to try and help it bag that next 3-star. Till then, I'm out.